Thank you for coming over here, taking out time to participate in the Credit Research Challenge. Can you quickly introduce yourselves and your college?
Hello, sir. I'm Shruti. I'm from SGM SOM IIT Bombay.
Hi, sir. I'm Sai Teja. I'm from SGM SOM IIT Bombay.
Can you please look at the camera while speaking?
Yes. Hi, I'm Shweta. I'm from Shailesh J. Mehta School of Management, IIT Bombay.
Hi, my name is Ranjana. I'm from SGM SOM IIT Bombay.
Okay. So, how was your preparation coming up to this level, and what was the difference you noticed while pursuing a project on credit research? And then obviously you must have studied and heard about lot about equity research and similar areas. So who's going to take this question?
Sir, I would take this. So first of all, I would like to thank the institution for the opportunity presented. So when we were going through the challenge, we noticed that we had a very limited source of materials available. There was a shortcoming, and we had our mentors guide us. That was very helpful from the AIWMI side, and they had provided us with mentors, and we had a lot of learnings in this sector. We never knew it was so big as compared to equity, and I think a lot of students should pursue.
So you really think that there's a good scope and demand coming up, going to come up for the professionals in the areas of credit, in the areas of fixed income, and you know, similar such research methodologies?
Yes, currently there have been a lot of issues, like the NPA issue and also the credit research would be a field which is definitely positive. It has a very positive outlook.
So we have a program called Certified Credit Research Analyst, which is one of the, you know, premier certifications in the area of credit. And now, you know, so you feel that programs like these will really help in enabling yourself and, you know, getting yourself skilled enough to get into and work into these areas?
Yes, definitely. Though we have worked a lot for this project, I still feel there is a lot much of knowledge that I need to gather in order to make such detailed analysis or report. So CCRA is definitely something someone who is into this field should definitely look into.
So how was the semi-final round? Exhaustive? Grilled? So so please share your experience. How did you feel? Like, were the questions quite relevant and you expected them, or they were something different, you know, from your preparations?
Although the questions were not very expected, it was a good testing of how we are able to apply what we had brought about in the project and what report we actually made, what are the understandings that we got from that report, and how we are able to come up with the final credit of a company.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for sharing your details, and wish you all the best for the next round. I'll quickly ask you for your introductions, your name and from which college you are.
Okay. Hi, I'm Vanshika from Flame.
My name is Raj Shah from Flame, postgraduate second year.
I'm Utsav Adani from Flame University.
And I'm Pratik Gandhi from Flame University.
So Flame, we are in Pune?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm also from Pune. And I sincerely hope that a team from Pune, you know, wins the CRC, Credit Research Challenge. Okay. Now to begin with, how was your experience in coming up to this, you know, semi-final round? What were the things which are different you noticed, which are not there in your regular curriculum, or maybe not there in your, you know, earlier assumptions and perceptions about being a research analyst in the areas of fixed income or credit? Who's going to take this difficult question?
So the whole concept, the credit rating itself was a new concept to us. So in our regular MBA or post-graduation courses, we do not have subjects on credit research per se. So there are a lot of new concepts that we learned because of this competition. And again, during our presentations, the jury told us quite a lot of inputs on those models that we have used. So that was a plus on being a part of this competition.
Great. Just one request. Can you look at the camera when you're speaking? Not me. Okay. So, and coming back and, so you feel that there is a need for different kind of knowledge and skill sets, which you must have experienced by for now, to actually get into and perform in the area of credit markets?
So as we've been all talking about getting into credit research and all these things, but even if a person's majoring in finance, he wouldn't be exposed to all the aspects of finance, and something like credit rating has become a very vulnerable thing, and every person who's both graduating in finance, this is an important aspect which he needs to go through. So I think the dominance and the relevance of it's been increasing more and more.
So one last question. Do you feel that a program like CCRA, Certified Credit Research Analyst, which has been now accepted by industry as one of the key programs in skill development in the area of credit, is going to help students like yourself and your peers and, you know, colleagues, especially who are looking to get into this area?
Definitely. Definitely, this program will help others learn the basics and learn it in a formal way, and also mingle with others who have the same kind of mentality and give them a platform to, I think, grow. So definitely this program will help a lot of students in the coming years.
Thanks a lot. You would like to add something?
Yes. So if someone wants to go into credit research or fixed income, then this is one of the programs, one of the certification that person can get. So in equities, we have CFA. Then for credit or fixed income, there should be something. And this is one thing that I believe holds in the future.
Many thanks and wish you all the best for next round.
Hello, I'm Saurabh Sharma from IIM Raipur, Team 197.
And Sajal Singh from IIM Raipur.
Devang Nagile from IIM Raipur.
Prabjot Singh from IIM Raipur.
Wonderful. So, coming from the state of Chhattisgarh, anybody knows Chhattisgarhi? No. Okay, no issues. That's not the question. So, how was your experience in coming up for and in preparing for this, you know, credit research challenge? And what difference did you find while studying or pursuing your post-graduation in finance? That is all I can presume. And obviously, things that you would have heard about, things you would have known from, you know, various speakers and your peers, etc., the areas of profession, you know, in the area in finance particularly. So maybe typically an equity analyst role, maybe typically a business analyst or a quant or a corporate finance role. So how, what difference did you find while pursuing this project for Credit Research Challenge and the things that you have learned so far?
So basically, while studying, while preparing for the video, for the report, we actually found that there are quite a few things which we are not aware of. Like, we focus majorly on equities, but fixed securities are also a very major role. For example, we recently came to know while studying only that the long-term capital gain tax was actually imposed to improve the fixed securities market rather than the equities. So that is how we actually learned a lot from it. And there are quite a few companies who come to our college for credit analyst and credit risk roles. So it actually enhanced our profiles and our work.
Well, that's great. And so how was your journey so far? I mean, some specific challenge you would like to mention that you found it interesting, exciting, as well as, yes, that was challenging? You'd like to take the question?
I guess challenges not as such, but I guess we working late nights, you know, working hard on the reports, on the presentation, coming up with every aspect of it. It was really nice experience.
So that's just a precursor of corporate world that you'll be getting into. So late nights, you know, and 24-hour working, and, you know, constantly on with your thinking caps as a credit analyst, because being into credit analysis, you actually need a lot of interpersonal knowledge and qualitative information that you need to understand. Anyways, my next question is, so do you think that programs like Certified Credit Research Analyst, CCRA, or maybe some other relevant programs which are typically into the skill building in these areas will really help students like yourselves and maybe some, you know, your peers who want to get into this domain?
Right, because in India, the bond market, the secondary bond market is at its primary stage. So in the coming years, roles like this will get more importance in a country like India. So yes, definitely students will benefit from these courses and these certifications.
So last question, like, how was your semi-final round? Good? Best? Better?
Anyway, we had a very good feedback from the judges. So we believe that we should be among the top 5 teams. And we are gearing up for the final presentation round.
Wonderful. So nice of you. Thanks for your time and all the best for your presentations.
Thank you.
Conservative approach is 4% growth, taking into account the variability which might come.
The reason we BA3 for international rating was they are sourcing their bonds from majorly from foreign markets with their a lot of investments of their borrowings.
My only question is, is this BBB a domestic scale or international scale?
Sorry, it is domestic scale. Crystal scale. Since AA rating was on
this, you appreciate that after AA there is a AA minus. There is an A plus A minus.
No, sir. The reason that you are taking is AAA, AA, BBB, BBB.
So we have downgraded by 2 points. So we have missed that. There is a AA plus AA, AA minus, A plus A, A minus.
This is the corporate rating that you're taking. We picked those data from the Crystal website, which stated the corporate company rating.
Point is,
the team from IIM Kozhikode, and they're going to introduce themselves.
Hi, I'm Pranav.
I'm Shubham. Hello.
I'm Jugal.
I'm Ishan.
Okay, so a very small question. So how was your experience coming up to this, you know, Credit Research Challenge, being a semi-finalist over here?
So it was a great experience in terms of that we started with a test or a qualifying round wherein our domain knowledge was tested, post which we had to prepare a report which would normally be prepared by an analyst in the business. So that was also as good as a practical experience. And in the semi-final round, as we have to present our same recommendation or the whole credit report, so this is some learning which we would have got only if we were professionals in credit rating agencies.
So you all are pursuing finance, if I'm not, you know, mistaken. I can presume that is safely great. So far you would have learnt about, you know, various domains in corporate finance and areas of equity research and analysis, etc. What was certain points which are quite different, and obviously, you know, you enjoyed going after them while doing this Credit Research Challenge project? You found that this is something different that you're doing. What was that one or two points you can share?
I think majorly what we study, we don't dive deep so much in the industry. So at least for Credit Research Challenge, that was something good, and we came to know a lot about the industry when we dive deep about the industry. So that's
secondly, when as you said that equity research is there or corporate finance is there, corporate finance is more so into application of the finances for operations, and equity research again it focuses on the equity. But whenever we are talking about credit rating, it would largely focus on the debt side, which we were a little unexposed to.
So what do you feel after going through this challenge and after coming to know about various areas of credit? Is there going to be a good market for young, you know, aspirants like yourself to get into and grow?
Definitely. The reason being that, you know, of late, if we look at the industry, so, you know, repaying the loans, and currently the banks are in a bad position. So I think there'll be a huge demand in the future for this.
So do you feel that programs like Certified Credit Research Analyst or similar such area, you know, programs which give you special skills and knowledge which are required in this domain can be helpful?
Yes, that is definitely going to be the case, because considering, so as everyone has already mentioned, this is something that we are not exposed to, something which we have not been doing. This is something which is
not taught in college, actually.
Correct.
We do not focus on credit analysis.
Yeah.
So we need some external help.
So this is a proper supplement to our learning as well, and this is going to help out us in the future. I just hope that this this program takes off, and then eventually more and more people get to know about this, and we think personally that this is a very good opportunity, and more people come to know of it and participate.
So you all guys are ready to become mentors next year?
Yes.
Okay, great. So good to have you here, and all the best for your final round. Thank you. I think you're the second team from IIM Trichy.
Yeah.
Wonderful. So we have a team here from IIM Trichurapalli. I hope I pronounced it correctly. Can you all introduce yourselves, please?
I'm Abhishek Mishra.
I'm Adarsh.
I'm Aditya.
I'm Srihari M.
Good to have you here. One quick question about your experience coming up to semi-final of CRC, Credit Research Challenge. And what was the differentiating factor you found that was unique, interesting, and something that you were not, you know, you did not have studied so far, or you were not aware of that?
The kind of questions that we faced in the initial round was the kind of question that we faced.
So what was that, you know, you must have noticed while going for the Credit Research Challenge, what was new and unique that you experienced And can you share certain, you know, these unique challenges that you faced over there?
The quality of questions that were there in the initial round were pretty good. Also, the involvement of every group member in the group activities, like every member has to be present for the activities. Otherwise, it won't be done in time. Okay. That was it. And then that kind of deadline that they gave, that was sufficient enough. That's something.
So, in terms of your learning so far in your, you know, academic pursuits, what was, you know, unique that you identified about credit research challenge in terms of the skills that you used?
First thing was that credit research challenge is the first of a kind competition like this, and we have seen from our colleges there were different like equity challenges which our college has won, and this is the first time that we are participating in something like this. So it was a great learning experience out of the classroom itself, because we got to learn a lot of things, and it increased our knowledge a lot.
Especially about this competition, it gave us a better idea about how this credit rating is done, how is this credit market works.
So do you feel that there are going to be areas of, you know, employability and jobs, etc., coming out in this specific domain of credit markets, maybe fixed income, debt, you know, debt analysis, etc.?
Can you take this question?
Yeah. So, like, as we see, there credit research is becoming very important in today's like corporate matters. So, basically, there are many companies which rely heavily on debt in order to fulfill their capital obligations. So definitely this will go a long way in identifying whether the various factors like the yield which a company, like the yield at which we give a loan to a company, and all those factors will be able to identify.
Great. So one last question. You feel programs like CCRA, that is credit research, you know, certified credit research analyst, then there are certain other programs across various bodies in the world which are particularly prominent from the areas of risk management, the areas of credit and debt income, you know, debt instrument analysis, etc. Do you feel that such programs can add a lot of value to your, you know, students who would like to start career in these domains? Would you like to answer this question?
It is a value addition in your resume as far as this is concerned. Like, you are restricting your scope of study into a field and you're gaining more knowledge onto that particular field. So that can prove, that can add more value to what you're pursuing, and that can align with your interest of this credit research.
Thanks a lot for your time, gentlemen, and I wish you all the best for the next round. Thank you.
I wish my money could be back, not on the upside. Yeah. I am not interested in how much money I can make, but how much money I can lose.
Yes. Okay. You'll be mindful of.
As of now, and the demand is expected to grow at 9 to 10%, which we consider is good. Regarding aluminium and power sector, since there is huge potential in the country regarding the power sector, and aluminium can be used in the cables for the electric power transmission, we see a chance of good growth in the aluminium as power sector. A brief intro about the management and the corporate governance part. So the board size is 8, and there is the executive chairman, executive vice chairman, and 5 non-executive directors. We didn't find any corporate governance committee in Vedanta. A couple of suggestions from our end, like empowering the independent directors and increasing the female presence, can be helpful as is suggested across the various industries in India.
Provides a cushion to the business is from any business side.
We know that Vedanta is highly deleveraged as compared to its peers. Consolidated balance sheet of Vedanta as compared to the standalone balance sheet is less leveraged. Gearing ratio for consolidated is 0.09 versus 0.22 for the standalone balance sheet. We can also see that Vedanta has paid back Rs 92 billion debt in the current financial year. Focus on deleveraging and free cash flow generation will drive down finance costs and see profit margins will go up in the future, which shows that it has a strong balance sheet going forward in the industry. Free cash flow and net sales have seen a sharp increase in the last couple of years. This shows the capability of the firm to generate strong cash flows coming forward.
Revenue of Vedanta is ₹717 million in fiscal year 2016-17, out of which the attributed profit after tax is ₹73 billion. The shareholder wealth increased by 205% in the fiscal year 2016-17, which led to the current market capitalization of ₹1.2 trillion. Vedanta has recently announced its investment plan of $10 billion in capital expenditure for the company.
25%, what is that? There was all of the components of the credit spread. There was a breakup for that. That's what it's trying. Credit spread, there must be some components. Like, what are those components and how much is the credit risk?
Okay, so here's a team from IIM Lucknow who have just come out of the semi-final round of Credit Research Challenge. And please introduce yourself.
Thank you, sir. I'm Samre Satpathy. I did my undergrad at NIT Rourkela. Then I worked for 3 years at Tata Steel. Currently, I'm a first-year student at IIM Lucknow.
Hello, sir. My name is Tanuj Agarwal, BTech from IIT Roorkee, currently first year at IIM Lucknow.
My name is Umang Sangoi. I did my civil engineering from IIT Bombay and worked for 2.5 years in construction, now studying.
Hi, I'm Abhishek Kulshrest. I'm a computer science engineer. Post that worked with JP Morgan for 3 years. Now I'm currently studying at IIM Lucknow. I'm a first year student.
Oh, that's very interesting. I think all of you have some experience, you know. That's wonderful. So more relevant experience would be yours. I think you were in JP Morgan, so technology side. Okay. And I presume that you will all be going for your majors in finance since you are here at Credit Research Challenge. So it's safe to assume that. Anyways, so how was your experience in, you know, preparing for Credit Research Challenge, and what unique things you noticed and you actually, you know, went through that experience? There was something that you would have find different from what you've been taught in the college, as well as something that, you know, you might be aware of in terms of your own, you know, presumptions. So can you take this question?
Yeah. So I think it was very wonderful experience for me. That's because in college, what happens is you get to learn the MANAC or basic FRA courses. Through this exposure, we got to understand the Reuters database, whatever the ESG factors are there, whatever the ratios are there. Even we learned about two models while studying this, the Altman Z model and the KMV model. So it was an interesting experience for me for that part.
Anything which you find different from equity analyst and the credit research that you did?
One of the most important things was that equity analysis is more of structured and it is available on a lot of places. So how to do a equity valuation, for example, the discounted cash flow analysis, which is very common. But for credit analysis, we could not find one particular way. There are lots of models and there is no defined way to do the analysis. So it was really interesting for us because we had to pick and choose what models and what analysis to do.
Great. So you feel that you're all coming from a very high pedigree B school and no, so you feel that certain add-ons, maybe something like a program called Certified Credit Research Analyst or maybe from some other world bodies, can actually give you a lot of, you know, value add in terms of upgrading your skill sets, upgrading your knowledge?
Yes, I think these programs actually add on to value because Abhishek himself is CFA level 2. I am CFA level 1 and he is also pursuing CFA level 1. So these programs actually give you more of a theoretical background, whereas the MBA more gives you more of a practical background. So it makes the theory strong, which is a better thing anyhow.
So since you are coming from a CFA background, I'm sure you have started your studies with that. You're already you pursued level 1.
I'm pursuing level 1.
You have cleared CFA level 2. Pursuing level 2. Great. So I think you would be better. You can better appreciate the fact that, you know, you found it something different than what you've been studying so far.
Yeah, so as we have already studied CFA covers a broad range of topics, whereas something like credit research or the credit research certification for that matter is very much focused only on the credit area. So this is something which we haven't had exposure to. Even in CFA, there is not it doesn't talk a lot about the credit research in particular.
So how was your experience so far? The semi-final round.
So it was good. So yeah, we were falling short on bit of topics, but yeah, we got to know that we should be strong in whatever we do and, you know everything about it before actually. So
thanks a lot for coming, guys, and thank you for your time and wishing you all the very best.
Thank you.
IIT Ghaziabad, and I'll just hand over the mic to introduce themselves.
Hi, my name is Rashi and I'm majoring in finance from IIT Ghaziabad. Hi, my name is Jyotsna Tripathi, IIMT Ghaziabad.
Hi, my name is Nomla Devdikshit, I'm from IIMT Ghaziabad.
My name is Ashwin Mansur.
Okay, so had a good semi-final round now. All ready for lunch. I think most of you be very hungry, so I won't take much of your time. So share a unique experience that you felt was different from what all things you have studied so far and while going preparing for a report for a credit research challenge.
So I'll keep it precise since it is lunch hour. This is the most practical implication of what we have studied so far in finance. This report analyzing financial statements of a particular business. So that was the most practical thing we could do, we have done so far in MBA. That's it.
And mostly, you know, whatever analysis we have done till now was majorly focused on equity, you know, equity research or equity analysis. And here we focused more on the debt side of the finance stream. So that is one thing which was absolutely different.
Like to add something?
I'll take a bit to the humor side. I have been fed up with helping my friends in marketing competitions, preparing them for their financials. This was the first finance event, core finance event, which I participated in. So, which included all my interests. So, that was a very good thing.
So, do you feel that some sort of, you know, programs like CCRA, you know, CFA to the equity analyst level, and similar such programs which various world bodies, you know, offer, global and Indian bodies offer, they can add value to your existing, qualification as well as can make you ready for the right jobs in these relevant areas?
Yeah, actually, they actually add a lot to your profile because I think I am the best example. I'm an engineer, a fresher engineer who came into finance profile. So when coming to like either maybe in the interview or going into future, if I want to show something in my resume like that I know finance rather than apart from degree, coming to other students, they can show that they have come from BCom backgrounds, BCom honors, they have read, they have done the accounting part. So it's not only for engineering, I'm just taking my example as the part. So it really helps actually.
So thank you very much for your time. I wish you all the best and look forward to see you in the finals. Thank you.
The audit committee shall consist of minimum 3 directors. In case of audit committee of Vedanta, there are all 3 members are there in the committee. All 3 are independent directors. The nomination and remuneration committee of Vedanta has 3 out of the 4, which is more than what is mentioned in the section 178. Also, if you see the board composition, half of the board members of Vedanta are independent directors. Now, we all know that independent directors are ensure that the business is run in ethical way. Also, the decisions which are taken by the management are in the to protect the interest of the shareholders and the owners. So based on a comprehensive analysis, what we recommend is the investors to buy the bonds of Vedanta. That's all from us. Thank you.
A couple of questions. So it's a, you're given a bond rating, right?
Recommendation.
It's buy.
Yes.
But shouldn't the bonds buy or sell rating depend also on the interest rate?
Yes.
I can have a AAA bond, but it's not priced well. So you don't haven't had any view of the bond price. How can you say it's a buy?
Valuation.
You're trying to normalize. What was the input feed?
Sir,
for Vedanta, how many years of data are you paying? You need a distribution for Montegal. How have you generated?
Yes, sir. So
how have you generated the distribution?
So for price, what we have done is we have taken futures price of the commodities.
You have taken futures price of the commodity,
the
distribution and picked up from there and
yes.
And then you use FUD to calculate the revenue.
For price, I have told you. The
you got the price. You
which?
I am Rohtak.
I am Rohtak. Okay, so here's a team from I am Rohtak just coming out of their semi-final round. I'd like to ask them to introduce themselves, please.
My name is Siddhesh Salkar.
My name is Tanmay Deshpande.
My name is Parag Navani.
Hi. So you are the last team, I won't take much of your time. How was your experience so far in terms of preparing for credit research challenge and the things that you have been studying so far or you have been taught or may have some experience in finance earlier? What was the unique difference over here?
Unique difference is that we never thought a company from the credit perspective. Like what we usually see is we see from valuation perspective or whether buying a stock perspective or maybe futures, but we never see from the credit perspective. So this competition really made us think about whether how credit analysis should be done, and we really explored about how analysis should be done, those things.
That's wonderful. So do you now understand that there's going to be a huge demand for professionals who are experienced and who are actually skilled and trained in the areas of credit, not just the credit from the rating perspective, but may, you know, even on the lending side, even from the treasury operations side as well, risk management side. So do you think that it's going to be a area where we can see a lot of employments?
Yes, obviously, given that our country has that NPA problem and many of the fraudsters are coming up in recently, so our country needs a professional line of thinking which helps to curtail all these issues. Many of the country, Western countries, have already adopted certifications like CFA, which are molding the professionals not only on technical grounds but also on the ethical grounds. So our country needs such kind of initiatives as well.